It's official. The holidays are here. On the one hand, on the other hand, the holidays can be stressful. So today we're going to talk about different tips that you can use and strategies to stay calm and sane throughout the holiday season. Now, if you're excited about staying sane this holiday season, go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. And if you aren't already subscribed, go ahead and subscribe and hit the bell so that you don't miss out on any future videos. If you feel more stressed out this time of year, you are not alone. This is a very stressful time of year for many of us because there are a lot more kind of events, engagements, expectations of us, buying presents, just being really busy, and a lot of times all those things add up and just cause us a lot of overall stress. And then on top of it, there are different like family dynamics or things that we might be dealing with, like we might be seeing relatives that we don't normally see for the first time in a long time, or maybe we wish that we had family to see but we don't, or for some of us it brings up memories of loved ones that are no longer here. And that can be really difficult. Or maybe you have a massive family that's overwhelming, or you have relatives that say things like,
"Are you doing something different with your hair? Why are you still single?
When are you gonna get a real job?"
There are also work engagements, stress in our relationships, stress because we aren't in a relationship, food-related stress. There's a lot. So how do we stay sane and calm and happy and grounded during the holidays? Here are some of the tips that I found to work for me. Number one is to define your non-negotiables. So by non-negotiables, I mean, what are the things that you do regularly that make you feel calm and grounded overall? So not necessarily what are the super fun things that you can do that are exciting, more like, what are the things that you can build into, or that you do build into your routine, that when you do them consistently, make you feel good? So for me, that means getting 8 hours of sleep every night, working out a couple times per week, meditating every day, and journaling every day. Those are my non-negotiables. You may have more or less than those for you, but those are the things that I found that when I do them consistently, I feel more calm and happy and grounded. That brings us to number two on the list, which is self-care. Self-care is very popular. It's a very popular phrase right now. And so I think it's worth mentioning that self-care doesn't necessarily need to be something big and elaborate. It doesn't need to mean that it's a day at the spa or something like that. It can really be as simple as just taking time for yourself to read a book or to go on a walk, or it could even just be like setting an alarm on your phone to go off a few times per day, and then when that goes off, you stop what you're doing, you close your eyes for 30 seconds, and you just breathe. Those are the sorts of things that can really help you feel nourished overall and help you to make sure that you're not kind of getting strung out or feeling stressed or letting things accumulate, because you're building in these moments of self-care throughout your day. What are those things for you? Go ahead and put it in the comments below. Let me know, like, what are the different self-care things that you do and are gonna continue to do in order to make sure that you feel calm and happy and grounded throughout this holiday season. Another really important one is sleep. When we get really busy, it's easy to deprioritize our sleep and get less and less sleep each night, which can make us more stressed out, tired, cranky, and it's overall bad for our mental health. So what we want to do is make sure that we're protecting our sleep time and making sure that we're getting good quality sleep by avoiding caffeine later in the day or too much sugar or a few extra cocktails in the evening, just making sure that we're well rested. Define your schedule. All of the events that you want to commit to, things that you know that you want to go do during the holiday season, go ahead and put them on your calendar, and then also find time to schedule the things that you want to do that are like holiday task related. For example, like getting the Christmas gifts that you want to get, or buying a Christmas tree, like all those different things, go ahead and put them on your calendar. They may be even simple, fun tasks that you do every holiday, but if you don't put them on your calendar, they may end up sneaking up on you, and so this is a way for you to feel organized and stay on top of it. There is nothing wrong with saying no. There is a lot going on during the holidays. There are different events and obligations and things to get done. And there are going to be times where people ask you out to dinner and you want to have a little bit of wiggle room so you can be flexible and say yes to the things that you'd like to do. But at the same time, you're probably going to get invited to things that you don't want to do, are too tired to do, you're feeling antisocial, whatever the case might be. There are going to be times when you're invited to do things that you don't want to do, and I just want to say that that's okay. It's okay to say no thank you when someone offers or asks you if you'd like to come along with them or go to a party or something like that. I think a lot of times we get nervous that people won't ask us again, or we have FOMO, or whatever the case might be. It's totally okay to say no. Just be sure you're not canceling on people last minute or doing things that are rude like that. Just saying no outright, no thank you, is not rude, and it's totally fine to do. So be sure to protect your time and your own mental health and well-being, and don't be afraid to turn down the things that you are too much or you really don't want to do. The key to making it through the holidays is really the same as any other time in the year. It's all about setting boundaries, finding balance, and staying grounded so that you can enjoy life as it comes. Now, if you've made it to the end of the video here, be sure to let me know in the comments below what was your favorite tip, and I hope that you all have a wonderful, beautiful, bountiful, joyous, calm, grounded holiday season. And if you haven't already subscribed, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. I'll see you all soon.